So you don't have to have a PhD in health economics to know that the baby boom generation is aging, and with aging you have lots of physical disability centered around our infrastructure, our muscle, our skeleton. Nobody wants to be an invalid. So this study is critical. If we can come up with ways to help this process, it will be extraordinarily cost effective in terms of taking care of people, but also it will help people have a much better quality of life.
And being able to stand up out of a chair, to be able to lift your groceries out of the trunk of the car, to be able to continue to live independently is the goal that everybody has. And maintaining muscle, maintaining strength is the key to that. So trying to find ways to make that more effective and make it easier for people is the goal of our work.
Scientists at the University of Kentucky and University of Alabama at Birmingham have joined forces to see if the most prescribed diabetes drug, metformin, can help older adults gain muscle mass.
Metformin has been used to treat diabetes for several decades.
It's the first line of defense in diabetics, and it is very effective in reducing blood sugar. There have been a lot of studies in animals as well as in humans and noting that it had some beneficial effects.
One of our hypotheses is that metformin also has a positive effect to help muscle remodel. If you're exercising, you're trying to build muscle, your muscle has to be able to adapt and remodel in response to that exercise. And that's a normal physiologic process. Some people don't remodel their muscle and don't build muscle as well as others, elderly people in particular.
It's going along with this new idea of precision medicine, that exercise doesn't work as well for all people, and that maybe if we can find things we can add on to exercise that would make everybody respond better, that this would be a really good thing. Give people the drug or a placebo, have them undergo a training regimen for 3 months, lifting weights, and then we just measure their muscle mass and their strength gains to try to see if metformin is beneficial and will help older people gain more mass and strength when they exercise. I have been doing studies in elderly individuals and trying to help them maintain function and prevent frailty. And I've had a colleague for many years who's at the University of Alabama at Birmingham, Marcus Bauman. We've noticed this phenomenon in our older subjects that when they do a weightlifting protocol, some benefit greatly and others do not. And so we joined forces and combined our data and are now working together.
We have significant strength in clinical and translational research through our CTSA. We have strength in diabetes and in metabolism and muscle biology. So I think it really leverages all of these different strengths, puts it together in one brain.
We had noted a feature of muscle that we thought might cause it to be more adaptable to exercise. We began to look in human muscle biopsies that we've taken from our research subjects and started to note that these same differences were appearing in their muscles at the cellular and molecular level. Following training, those people with these features in their muscles seemed to gain the most mass and strength. And then through studies from our lab as well as many other labs, what we discovered was the drug metformin seemed to promote these changes in muscle. So it's sort of like putting A plus B equals C. So we put it together and thought maybe by giving people this drug before they start to exercise, it would help their muscles then be able to adapt more readily. So it's really combining very mechanistic studies on muscle, now applying those things that we've learned to people in an exercise trial.
The most exciting part of the study is looking at the participants who are in the study, who are truly excited and who really love to be here. They're getting stronger. They enjoy coming 3 times a week to pump some iron. And seeing the enthusiasm and the excitement in the eyes of the participants is really, truly gratifying.
Scientists across the country are looking at metformin as an anti-cancer and anti-aging treatment. And Drs. Kern and Peterson are eager to contribute to this emerging national initiative.
So we could be part of this really large initiative to try to determine if metformin may be one of the first drugs given just as an anti-aging drug. I feel like there's a lot just on the horizon in terms of trying to help older people maintain their quality of life, and that being part of that and trying to contribute to that knowledge base is very exciting to me.
Thank you.